Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Dear students, today we are here, me and Sister Shabano, with another topic which is very important, anger management. This topic is important because anger is very common emotion, common human emotion, but it is negative emotion. And we need to understand how to manage it so that we can live in harmony with others. So I'll start with the first slide, but I would like to have Sister Shabana's opinion on the topic.
Yeah, this topic is very much near to me because I personally was suffering with this disease, anger,
and it's
So it's very important to understand all the positive and negative aspects of anger. You know, this does also have positive aspects, and we're gonna discuss, and this is very important to understand how to create a peaceful and peaceful environment, whether it is on individual level or collective level. So it's a very, very important topic. Jazakallah for adding this.
I agree. For any age group, it's equally important, whether it's kids, it's a bigger kids, smaller kids, or middle-aged people, or old people. Everyone has to control the anger. We don't have an excuse that someone is scared, oh, let it go. Someone is old, oh, let it go. No, it shouldn't be someone's habit, being angry. And there's a religious perspective to it as well, that it is a true believer do not remain in state of anger for long. It's so that's what we are going to discuss, like occasional anger versus staying angry. So if you are staying angry for most of the time, you need an anger management. Day to day, occasionally anger comes, and we will talk about managing that as well. So I'll start with the definition of anger. Anger is an intense emotion you will feel when something has gone wrong or someone has wronged you. It is typically characterized by feelings of stress, frustration, and irritation. Everyone feels anger from time to time. It's a perfectly normal response to frustrating or difficult situations. So Sister Shabano, what do you think about this sentence? It's perfectly normal. Is it normal to be angry?
Yeah, it is embedded in our personality, in fact. What I learned about over the time, that we should not be negative about that if we are angry. So this is a human being is, you know, has two parts of the personality. One is the spiritual and one is the physical part. So we are in physical area, we have a lot of organs, and in the on the emotional side, we have those spiritual organs. And one of the spiritual emotion, or you can say feeling, is like love, like kindness, like empathy, like compassion. Anger is also a part of our personality, and there is no one is like out of this thing. There is no one who is not aware of this word anger. Either he is suffering with this problem, or he is like going through or in a situation that he has to face someone's anger. So over the time, there are many researches went on this topic. There are many books written on this topic. Many writers have spoken on this, because over the time, humanity suffered a lot because of this, not only on the individual level, on the nations suffered because of the anger. So first, we should all know that it is part of our personality. So how to use this, how to manage this, how to utilize this, or how to settle it. This is what we are going to talk about. Inshallah.
Inshallah. That's very true. Some thought-provoking questions here. Is anger a good or bad thing? Is our body's way of telling our body's way of telling us that we don't like what's going on? It can make us say things we don't really mean, or do things we would never do if we were calm and in control. So these two bullets tell me that it's not really a good thing. Though it's natural to have anger on something when some undesired goes around you, something which goes against your wishes, it's normal. But these two bullet points are telling me that it's not a good thing. It's our body's way of telling us that we don't like what's going on. This is sort of indication, right? This is sort of indication that our body, when we are angry, our heart starts beating fast, and sometimes you feel heat in your head, and there are some physical symptoms, and you have strong urge of either saying something bad or doing something bad, or you know, being offensive or defensive or offensive. So that's the thing, that if it's a bad thing, then should we avoid it? And can we avoid it 100%? What we should do? To me, it's a continuous process. It's not one-time thing. What do you think, Sister Shabana?
Yeah, it's a continuous process. You know, every time you don't face the same situation. Even if you feel the same situation, you are not the same. So every time it's a new learning for you, and new questions arise, and new way to deal it. So I believe this thing is showing us that it's an indication, so that we can take a pause. We will discuss it later, but it's an indication that be serious about it. There is something you have to give attention, anger. And I think there is a research which tells that small things which we ignore by the time, they are the reason of trauma and depression in the longer run. So if we don't handle, if we don't manage our trivial anger, they will end up in depression, in very vicious cycle of our bad mood. So one thing is, make sure that be conscious about our own behavior, because we can do something on our own self. So we have to be very vigilant about. So it's very awakening topic, because it is about me. It is about all the kids that who are suffering with this, that they become angry. Even if their parents or one of the elders is having that attitude. So how to deal with that? So I think itself, anger is a part of our life. Like nowadays, we cannot have an idea that Corona will leave the society in. I don't think we will be able to, like, as it is the situation prevailing now, it's same goes with anger, that it will there. So we have to accept it, that okay, it will be our partner, but how to deal with this partner, this is a question.
Very right. It's gonna be there, and it is there in our time, day-to-day life. In a day, there would be like so many things which we can count on our fingers, countless things which maybe we cannot count on, which make us angry, and we have to manage it every time it happens. And why we need to manage this? If we think about that point, then this thing comes in my mind that it eats up your energy. It is your energy taker. It's energy consuming thing. That if you're angry on something, that time you can spend constructively, right? And it is scientifically proven, neurologists have proven this thing, when you become angry, your brain development, or what I should say, your brain do not respond to the things in a good way, because you do not produce happy hormones in your body. And you do not respond to things in a good way in future as well. It affects your brain cells' capability of seeing things positively further as well. So that is why it is important to manage. And I was reading this 10-second rule. We will come to management part, but I will start with this very simple tip, that if you are angry and you need to act, or you need to react on that particular moment or event happened which made you angry, you need to take a pause for 10 seconds. Just do nothing. Just count to 10 in your head. And often people say, recite something 10 times, say Astaghfirullah 10 times, but the scientific reason behind that is take a pause. So Astaghfirullah will earn you good deeds as well. So say Astaghfirullah 10 times in your head, take a pause, and you will feel the change or the shift in your mood. And you will feel that your hormones, basically these are hormones. The human have those glands, pituitary glands, you guys have must read in biology. Those pituitary glands produce all kind of hormones, happiness, sorrow, or anger. So when you take a pause, that gland takes a time to normalize itself, and it produces some substance which, you know, make that is like contrast to the anger hormone, and you slow down a bit. It does not mean that your anger vanishes, but you slow down a bit. So take 10 seconds and then act on it, and then again try to act in a calm way. We will read the tips in further slide, that how you can be further calm about your anger. So I'll move to the next slide. Sister Shabana, would you like to read?
Yeah, sure. According to a study published in The Guardian, May 12, 2019, feeling anger can alter the way we view this. Studies have shown that it can make us more impulsive and make us underestimate the chances of bad outcomes. The article also highlights that the way we process angry feelings also contributes to our mental well-being.
I think it's kind of the same thing which I said earlier, that you lose the ability to use your brain in a positive way, where you can, like I said, it said it makes you impulsive and make us underestimate the chances of bad outcomes. That you are not thinking rationally. And you are losing the capability of the brain to think rationally. So it says that the research has proven that it affects your future decisions as well. Future decision power as well.
Exactly. Bushra, Salman, I want to add just that, our life is going on a focus-based moment-to-moment travel or journey, you know. It's a focus per moment. It's a focus per second. Even we offer prayer, we are asked to be focused, you know. So, and we are human mind and human body and human personality is controlled by mind. And our mind can only focus one thing at a time, you know. So the focus is per minute. We need to understand it in detail. So that's why I'm explaining it in a bit deep way. That our focus is working per moment, per second. So we are limited in this way that we can do one thing at one time. So when we, in one of the hadith, it says that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if you are angry, if you are sitting, stand up. If you are standing, sit down. If you are standing, have sip. Or change your position which you are. What is it? What's the scientific aspect behind it? That you are disconnecting that emotional stress, with your body. Your movements are giving signal to the mind that position is changed. So the moment it detracts that focus of intense, stressful situation, The moment it is disconnecting with that situation by sitting or by standing up, by having a sip of water, it gives you a pause. That pause, maybe if it is of 10 seconds or more or a bit less, it will give you a time to focus again and disconnect and manage your stress feelings in this way. So this will lead to you to be calm and regain the energy. It will definitely, the way you beautifully said that, it will generate few hormones, positive hormones. And that to buy time is basically to buy or to have more positive or more calm moments. So our focus is settled in this way. So we are very much bound in the area of focus. You know, human beings are always, if we as a nation, if we are focusless, then we are detract. The same way, in on a momentarily basis, if we are not focusing and on a positive side, obviously we are not on the right track. So giving a pause is the basic, yeah, detract. So coming back to the track, we have to give pause. So for that, on scientific basis, you have to count till 10, or in our ahadith, mashallah, subhanallah, way back, our prophet has also mentioned the same pattern. So the reason behind it was the same, that we are disconnecting the emotional area of the stress. So this was, we should know the reason why we are doing.
Right. So you were saying that we need to buy time to readjust our focus. So that's the concept behind taking the pause, right?
Yeah. Beautifully summarized. Jazakallah.
The secret of anger, the only thing that makes you angry is you. Do you believe this secret? This is an amazing.
No.
We don't believe, right?
Vishal Salman, I don't believe. Can you?
Yeah, that's the problem. It lies in all of us. That we say, our kids say, you made me angry. Like, and I tell to my kids, you made me angry. And like it's whoever the party is, the both parties blame the other party that you made me angry. So no one can make you angry but you. So always remember, the anger is your emotion. You have to own it. It is your response to someone's action. I'm not denying that action can be offensive, and the anger can be in defense to that offense, right? I'm not denying that fact. But own that defense mechanism. Own that you're doing that anger in that defense mechanism. You found something offensive and then you became angry. It's not the other person who is making you angry. Other person is using his free will. Remember, we read about the free will. We talked about the free will. So other person is making use of his free will. Now, I'm agreeing to the point that there can be situations which are not positive from your perspective. It's negative. Somebody can behave in a way which is not suiting your personality or your heart or your desires or your situation. It can go against you. But how you react is your depiction of your will, your free will, right? So somebody, I'm just closing this point and I will let you speak. So somebody is exhibiting their free will by acting in a certain way. Now you have a choice. You have a free will to act in a positive way, B, negative way. So you would be exhibiting your free will. Yeah, Sister Shabanu.
No, I want to ask if someone has done to me, Sister Busha Salman. No,
sorry?
He has done wrong to me. He has done wrong to me, or he or she. No, he was wrong. She was wrong. And because of him or her, I am angry. And he is the reason behind my anger. I have nothing to do with it. I was going so good. My day was so good. So why it is me? Still,
I have answer for that.
This is very important. Please do answer me.
I have answer for that.
Yeah.
He or she is the reason of your anger. He gave you the reason to be angry, right? But it's not necessary that you be angry on that. Two wrongs do not make one right. One wrong plus one wrong is not equal to one right, right? It's the equation.
Okay.
The equation of if two negatives do not make one positive, right? This is a simple math equation. Minus plus minus one. Minus one plus minus one. What it makes? It makes minus two.
Yeah.
Right? So why you want to do something whose it's simple math. We don't have to go in the philosophy of that.
Okay, now tell me.
I'm not done yet.
What to do with my anger?
I'm not done yet. Please don't be angry.
Okay.
I'm not done yet. So minus one plus one equal to zero. So it means you are utilizing the situation. It's a simple math.
Okay.
So why you have to act positive if somebody is negative? Because you are responsible Muslim. You are responsible human being. Forget about being Muslim. You're a responsible human being. You want to dissolve the situation. You don't want to be equally angry by making the situation worse. Now, please go ahead.
No, now I'm angry. Someone has provoked anger in me. No, I have this anger. Where should I keep this anger? How should I diffuse this anger? I'm having this person. Now tell me, what should I do?
Okay. The first thing is, which I told, that you should not try to not get angry. But even if you try and anger comes, like it comes inside you as an emotion. You can't do it, right? You can't do anything. It has come, then it has come, right? Then what is right thing to do? Follow the footstep of Shaitan, what he did. He was angry on creation of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and he kept on doing wrong things. And there he is rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forever, right? You want to do that? Go ahead, do it. And secondly, if you are angry, you need to do sabr. That is concept of sabr here, because that's where our test comes. That's where you are going to earn good deed. That is the religious perspective to it. So we discussed both benefits. There are worldly benefit to it, because if you show anger in return of anger, or you show anger in return of undesired situation, it's going to give you worldly, it's going to give you loss, and also it's going to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be angry, not because he wants to be angry, because he knows that it's your betterment is in peace. Because the ultimate goal in this world is to live in harmony with others. You would be disrupting that harmony. One person acted in a bad way to disrupt that harmony. Why you want to add to that?
Okay, that makes sense.
Right? It makes sense. So we covered both aspects, worldly aspect and the religious aspect of it. In both ways, anger is not good. We would try to diffuse it as soon as it comes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, Mr. Salman, one more thing. Should we go ahead or cover the...
No, please go ahead. We will. The next slides are very quick. Okay. We'll just read them. Yeah.
Okay. If what about this saying that I cannot tolerate the wrongdoing?
I cannot tolerate the right thing is a wrong sentence in itself. The tolerance comes when there is a wrong thing. If everything is right, what's the point of tolerance? Right? So I heard this sentence a lot, and at some point in life I said it also.
I had
enough. I can't tolerate. Actually, the problem with me is I cannot tolerate something wrong with me. You have to tolerate the wrong. Who tolerates the right things? The right things are cherished. They are enjoyed. They are not tolerated. So that's the answer.
Okay. So thank you. It was amazing to have answers.
Yeah, no, these were actually amazing questions. That's why the answer was good. So coming back to this slide, we are not going to say you made me angry. The focus should be on I. The focus should not be on you next time. Our dear students are going to do same in home, in class. When you become angry, the focus should be I, that I own my emotion. I became angry. I have to do something about it. The other person has exhibited his free will, I'm going to exhibit my free will, and I'm going to choose to be to stay positive and stay calm about it. That's the moral of the whole conversation.
Amazing.
Okay. Yeah. Now there is some situation, like it's just an example. Someone takes the last cookie. Someone takes the last chocolate cookie. So these are the things in the childhood or in the age, in this age which you guys are that you, it's not about just cookies. Somebody takes your favorite thing, or somebody, some sibling is not being fair. Some classmate is not being fair. Sometimes you feel that teacher is not being fair. It can be in your head. So what do you need to do? You need to look at the positive aspect. Here I would say, Sachcha Shabano, one very important thing. When you are angry, it does not always mean that you are right as well. You need to learn to give benefit doubt of other people. Whether it's your teacher, really? Whether it's your mother, father, sibling, friends. Maybe they are not doing it to make you angry. Maybe they are just doing it because they have to do that thing, right? So always first give benefit of doubt. What is benefit of doubt? That other person is not doing this intentionally to harm me or to make me angry. This is they are doing it in their certain situation. They live their
own. It's not always about me.
It's not always about me. They live their own, not their own reality. They think from their own.
Yeah.
They see things from their own perspective. They have yeah. their own vision. They have their own way of doing certain things. So if they are doing it, maybe that. If they are doing certain things in their way, and maybe this thing is offending me, maybe that's...
Exactly.
So anger is always not right. Anger is not always justified. Sometimes it's justified. I just realized that we were talking about justified anger so far. That if your anger is somehow justified, that somebody did something and it made you angry, but there can be situation that somebody didn't do anything to make you angry and you are angry, right? So we take into account both situations. So first you need to analyze whether this thing is worth being angry. Am I angry rightfully? I know when you are angry, you cannot think like that. That's why the 10 second pause comes into the picture. At that moment, you need to realize that am I rightfully angry or not? So that's the thing.
Amazing. Jazakallah. It is amazing point.
Jazakallah. The next slide is you can control what other people do. You can always control what you think. You can control your anger. Sister Shabano, again, I think it's kind of the same thing which we talked about, free will. You want to add something?
Yeah, I want to add that other person's behavior or doings have nothing to do with you. You have your own way of life. So don't change your ways. On their own influence, by their influence, don't give your remote to the other person. That is, whenever they want to switch the channel. You don't be a robot, you know. Otherwise, you will be handled or mishandled by other person. Be your own boss. It is like that. You have to command yourself. You have to judge yourself. You have to be vigilant about yourself. We learned by the time, Shah Salman, that it's all about our perception. It's all about how we perceive things. If somehow we are able to understand the other person's the way he...
You are muted mistakenly. Okay, I thought. Okay. No, now it's good. So, yeah, please carry on. Yeah.
So I think it's all about... are not always about me, and we should not measure our attitude. We should not settle our attitude, or we should not define our pattern by looking at others' behavior. This is something which is not logical. Otherwise we will be dependent on others' behavior. Our behavior's result is our own behavior.
Yes.
Should be our own behavior, not like other person's behavior. Should lead us where to go.
Right.
I think this is very important. We should be our own leaders. And our focus should be what we are given, all the education. And I think everything is written in Quran. There is nothing which is left. you know, all sorts of things. Even we, how type of things we can think, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already answered us that in future you may think like that. In future you may you may perceive like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has settled everything. So sure, so should be our book. Otherwise, intellect and wisdom comes with time and experience.
Right, you're right. I would like to put this slide into a hypothetical situation. For example, there are two students in the class, and one is always annoyed by another. Just a hypothetical situation. It can happen, and it's very likely to happen. It can happen. It's very negative example, but it has a positive message in it. That if a student is very annoying, or someone finds annoying. He's not annoying in nature, but certain actions are negative to other students. He finds it very negative actions. And he's always annoyed by that person. So what is negative attitude? Negative attitude here is to, in response, every time responding negatively to that action, which is annoying that the other student, student B. I would call student A and student B. What is positive behavior here? The student B always think that I am in control. I'm not letting him control me. Now, it's not that he's directly controlling you, but if you will react, it means you're in charge, but you are not letting yourself be in charge of yourself. You are giving your control to other person. Irrespective of the fact that he is making you angry intentionally or unintentionally, right? You are giving your control to someone else. Why you want to do that? It means you are a weak person. So what would be the positive situation for student B? That he would think, no, I would not let anybody to control me. I would act positively no matter what. And I would not care what he or she is doing. So that's being...
He will earn
self-control. So the person who earns self-control is a power. Like you said, being your own leader. The person who earns self-control can earn anything. So self-control, this is a practice of self-control. It's like exercise of self-control. That you are your own in charge. Nothing can bother you. You become a strong personality. And believe me, everyone likes strong.
Does it call emotional intelligence?
This is very right. You put it in very perfect terminology. It's a perfect term. It is called emotional intelligence. And that you are not behaving in a negative way on every small thing. You are consuming your emotional energy in a positive way. You are consuming it where you should be consuming, like giving time to friends, having playful time with them. Having a nice chit chat, or spending nice time on nice games, or just doing study circles, etc., rather than being angry and consuming your emotional energy. So this is being emotionally intelligent. So this is called emotional intelligence. You put it in perspective. Thank you.
That's your learning.
So our learning is an emotionally intelligent person would be in control. Always in his own control, in his or her own control.
Exactly.
This is very beautiful slide. Hot thoughts feed the fire of anger, not fear. I hate this. I never get what I want. I always get. He always gets her way. And then cool thoughts put out the fire of anger. It's not what I wanted, but I'll survive. I can deal with this. Getting angry isn't going to help. This isn't worth getting angry about. So these are just examples of the thoughts you can have in those 10 seconds or later on when you are pondering before responding. So this would stop you being impulsive. So if you keep on thinking negative, it would just add fire to your anger. So just try to calm down yourself with the positive thoughts. Sister Shabana, would you like to say something about it?
Yeah, there is a very minute thing that if someone is provoking you, don't answer that person. Stay calm. Stay quiet. You don't have to answer everything. You don't have to bother. what other person is saying. If he is provoking, someone is provoking, or the situation is provoking. Sometimes the situation is provocative. You don't have to do something. Sometimes when you don't do something, that is the most important work you are doing.
Not doing sometimes, is also great. Something.
Yeah. So if you're not answering, that is the best answer. If you're not reacting, that is the best reaction. So first of all, because the situation is not always at the peak in the start, it goes like gradually. So don't push that situation to that extent. So if you are thinking that there is something or there is something fishy or there is something not good, so be vigilant and be passive. Positively passive. Don't rush towards acting back or reacting or answering or this is the tip which I think it will help.
Yeah, that is very good thing, and this is proven by Sunnah as well, that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, used to be silent when he didn't like anything. So and there is also another hadith that either say good thing or stay silent. These are very small ahadith, but they are very important. They are
full of wisdom.
Big message in it.
We have to practice this. We have to try to practice this.
Right, try to practice it. Very right. So anger management through Quran, Quran teaches us every single thing. It's a code of conduct. So let's see what it teaches us about anger. Anger management is positive quality of believer. Positive wellness can be termed as positive spirituality. For example, there is a verse in Quran which says, with reference to the believers, that they forgive people when they are angry. This is beautiful. It means that positive spirituality is based on the formula of anger management rather than on trying to become a person who has no feelings of anger. The formula of positive spirituality can be summarized thus: turn your negative sentiments into positive responses, make friends out of enemies. So I would like to read this again. It means that the positive spirituality is based on formula of anger management rather than on trying to become a person who has no feelings of anger. So it means it's inevitable to be angry, but when you turn, it's anger will come anyway. But when you will turn that anger into positive feelings, that is a spiritual experience, and I know it comes with the practice. Easy said than doing, but it definitely brings positive results in life, and it's proven from Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that Quraysh used to do awful things to annoy him and make him angry, but he showed ultimate patience, and what was the result? The enemies of Islam became friends. So that's the example we need to implement in our life, that we can make friends. I have an example. I was telling my kid the other day, there used to be a girl in my class who used to bully me. But we became very good friends afterwards because I never gave response. My kid was asking, what did you do to be friend with her? The only thing I did, I was thinking, did I do something? And it was not intentional, believe me. I didn't have any plan to make her friends. It was just, then I thought, what did I do to make her friend? I did not do anything. Every time she used to bully me, I used to smile and move on. And one day she was very friendly, and she was all, and that was start of our friendship. Because she tested me by all means, and she was like, she is not going to be crap. She's not going to be annoyed at all. And then we used to be very, very good friends. So I just wanted to tell that how you can be friends. So
doing nothing as a reaction has worked a lot. It's true. It's true. We should practice equally.
Exactly. Sister Shabana, would you like to read next slide?
Yeah, sure. Hadith of Prophet, peace be upon him. One day a man visited Prophet of Islam and asked, O Prophet, please advise me a formula of success. Prophet of Islam stated, La taghzib, don't be angry. Don't be angry means don't get angry when even when provoked, respond positively, even in negative situations, always adopt positive thinking. Wow.
Right. I think it's all we have already discussed, that positive thinking, don't be angry. And this is also Hadith. And remember, you will get reward as well. Like, it's acting upon any of the ayat and Hadith, you will get reward. So it yields benefits of both words, this word and word hereafter, not being angry. Exactly. So it has so much rewards and fruits to it. Yeah. Anger releasing method, Sister Shabana, would you continue reading, please?
Yeah, please. Anger releasing methods: take a break from angry situation, be silent, go to your room or outside the yard, shoot some basket or play ball, exercise, stretch, run, jog, skip rope, jumping jack. Art activities: draw, color, paint, play with pets, dog, cat, drink cold water, having ice cream, talk to mom and dad or an adult, how you feel, pray, recite duas, for example, A'udhu Billah Min Shaitanir Rajeem. These are the part of our sunnah, and we already know.
Right.
I believe if situation is we are not able to handle the situation, should we talk to our elders or someone? What do you think?
We can talk. Talking is not a bad thing about your anger. But first we need to, the very first step should be to dissolve the anger, right? If you will be talking immediately to someone, you would be talking and angry, and you can make someone else as well angry. Sorry.
Really?
So the first thing you need to learn is dissolving your emotions, which are at the peak. All these actions, they are basically doing that same thing. You are science students, or some of you must have read somehow in the science that it's all hormones which produces all these emotions. So these are activities are recommended because they would dictate your body or distract your body, and the body will start producing other hormones as a result of these activities. There is a hormone called dopamine. When you exercise or when you jog, that is also released, and that is hormone of happiness. So it would dissolve your anger, and you would be like, why I was angry? And drinking water is also sunnah when you are angry. And changing the position is a sunnah. Like if you're sitting, stand up. If you're standing, sit down. If you're sitting, lie down. Just change the position. So there is a scientific, later on, scientist has discovered that it has so much benefit to it, has a wisdom behind it, that when you change position, it alters the state of your body, and it alters your hormones and everything. So, and then there is another tip, that do wudu. Do perform wudu, right? And because you're using water, because I think, if I'm not wrong, the word of Hadith is the water of the wudu, it's like adding water to the fire of anger. You are just, calm. It has calming effect on your personality, right? So it has spiritual benefit as well as the physical benefit. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept all those things to benefit us physically and spiritually, doing wudu, doing namaz. So coming to your point, after all this, doing any one of this, just not all of this, doing any one of this, and then talking to someone, if you still feel anger, it means it really hurts you, right? And Islam does not stop us, but then talk to a sensible person. If you think if there's some mature person in your life, some mature friend, some sensible friend, some teacher who listens to you, maybe father, mother, elder sibling, elder cousin, some role model in your life, or somebody you look up to, it's okay to share your feelings. And if you are sharing your feeling with the intention of resolving the matter, then it's really good. It is encouraged. What do you have to say, Sister Shabana, about it?
Yeah, it's so beautiful to read that if you're angry, recite A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. You know how it is beautiful that as a kid who runs towards his mother for help, so we are directed to call for Allah's help. How it is beautiful relationship of a believer with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I was enjoying the moment when we all can have this practice that whenever we feel wrong, we are able to remind ourselves that we have to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying these words and these verses. So it is beautiful. So how it is impossible to be God conscious always, Shah Salman?
It's beautiful.
For peace, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then afterwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we are truly intentionally peaceful person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will surround us with good people, good mentors, and they will guide us to the right path. And we have our book Quran, which is always there. We have to make a habit to question and process that question in ourselves, and then open the book, and it has on all the.
You became mute, Sister Shabana. Accidentally, okay, no worries. You accidentally became mute. Yeah. So you are saying Quran has the answer. If you're angry, yeah. open the, on any matter.
I think
on any matter, open the book. Open the Quran.
Yeah,
read it with meaning. Read it with meaning. You will find your answers, right?
Yeah.
This is very spiritual message, and we will discuss in details when we will read the benefit of Quran in our long course.
Inshallah.
Okay, this is class activity time. It's a quiz for you guys. Does anger win you friends? So you have to answer these four questions, but not there's written yes or no. You have to answer in yes or no, but then you have to explain why. So you have to explain why as well. Has anger helped you get good grades on school? Yes or no? Whatever your answer is, you have to justify the answer with the why. Has anyone ever said, I want to be your friend because you're so good at becoming angry? Yes or no? And why? Has your mom or dad ever been nicer to you because you got angry about something? Yes or no? Why? Or think of it that if this situation happens, then what if this situation happened to you, then answer accordingly. If it situation did not happen to you, but imagine as if it is happening to you, and then answer. Have you ever fallen asleep with a smile on your face, thinking about all the times that you got angry that day? Yes or no? And why? Why is not that? That you are angry and you go to sleep smiling. Is it possible? Why it's not possible? So you have to ponder on all these things and write down in your own words. I just need your thoughts. That's important. That's all. And I would request your amazing instructors in the class to submit your responses. And thank you so much, everyone. We will be together
listening.
Another amazing topic. Jazakallah khair, Sister Shaba.
Jazakallah, Assalamu alaikum.